There was a time when we used to circle interesting opportunities with coloured pencils while scanning job advertisements in newspapers. Or there were circles that we quickly scribbled on paper to highlight important notes in a meeting. I'm going to explain how to do this highlighting technique, this circle technique, using the pen tool and the brush tool together in After Effects. As a first step, let's open a new project in After Effects, open a new composition. I'm going to open a 1928 1080 composition. The background can be black, and I'm going to add the newspaper clipping here. You can find newspaper clippings online. You can also download a sample newspaper clipping from freepeek.com. I'm going to add the newspaper page or the newspaper clipping, the newspaper sample, to the workspace. We can add this later, but keep it in the workspace. First of all, I hide it and I right-click in the workspace. I click New Solid, I click OK. Look, a red solid layer has been added. On this, we will draw the circle we want to draw, the circle we want to animate. And we're going to do this with the pen tool. I'm taking the pen tool. Let's start from here. I'm going to draw a circle like this. That's my intention. How do we draw it with a pen? I'm going to want to give it that kind of movement. Let's say we draw a circle like this by dragging the dots. You can narrow it a little bit. You can edit them later in this way. Let's do this editing until it's the way you want it. So our goal is to create a hand-drawn oval shape. At the point where you think it's okay, I'm leaving it like this. Now I'm creating a new layer, and we can change the name of this one, by the way. We can rename it to make it look nicer. I'm going to call it Path. We'll use that in a moment. Now I'm going to create a new solid layer, and let's name it directly here. I click on Circle and click on OK. Then I double-click on this newly created solid layer. Look, there will be an edit here when I double-click on it. So we're in this. Now we're going to need the Brushes panel. If you don't see this panel, you can select the Brushes option under Windows. Or you can access this panel by pressing Ctrl-9 on the keyboard. Let's leave this panel open somewhere. I'll grab Brush from the toolbox and the values in the panel will be activated. We will now try to create a line effect here. You can enter values close to these values for now. By playing with the values here, our goal is to get a more natural look. When I approach the workspace, I see that there is such a brush. I click once on the scene to make use of this brush. I clicked. Now we have our brush here. Now here's what we're going to do. We have just drawn a path. I go into Path, I go into Mask, and under Mask 1 you will see Mask Path. I copy it with Ctrl-J. Then I go inside Circle, under Paint Inside Effect, I select the path inside Brush and paste it here with Ctrl-V. After pasting, the line we just drew will come here. In this case, I can make the path behind invisible. The purpose of using this path is just to draw this path here, this line here. After switching to the Composition tab, look here. There is an option called Paint on Transparent. If I turn this option on, the background will be transparent and only the line we draw will be visible. If you have been able to follow these processes so far, it's a piece of cake. Now we will move on to the animation part. If there is such a problem here, you can scroll this back to the beginning. We had to do this pasting with the timeline at the beginning. We missed that. I've moved it to the beginning. And after moving it to the beginning, the timeline will appear from zero, and so will our brush line. You can check the settings similar to the settings we just made here. You can adjust the thickness of the line here. You can set the line angle here. See? Some places will be thinner and some places will be thicker, and this will give a more natural line effect. By adjusting the values here, you can prepare the most natural look for yourself. You can lower the hardness value. Lowering the hardness value will increase the softness of the edges of the lines. You can also change the roundness to adjust the ovality of the lines. It looks good like this. I don't recommend playing with the spacing. It will leave a gap between the brushes and it will be far from a natural look. We can adjust it to 25%, so it will look like a complete line. Now that we have determined how our line will be, we can animate it. When the timeline starts, there is an option called End in Stroke Options. End is currently 100%. 100% means that all of these lines are visible. When we lower it, see the line decreases, and when it is 0%, it means that it will not be visible at all. So, what do we do? By keyframing the end value, we will draw a line from 0 to 100%. I do it right away. When the end value is at 0, I click on the stopwatch and add a keyframe here. In the first second, I make the end value 100%. I select both keyframes and press F9 on the keyboard so they are a bit softer. I open the graph editor, select the keyframe on the right and move it a little bit to the left, so this is the line angle you should get, and close the graph editor. Now we can start analyzing our animation. I play the animation, let's see what it looks like. I press play and look, it starts fast and finishes slowly. This adds a little more naturalness to the animation. And that's how we created the line animation, as you can see. Now I'm going to show you how we can integrate it into the newspaper cube product we added at the beginning. But if you're already using After Effects, basically, and you know the layer logic, you will already see the effect when you put it on it. I made the newspaper visible. I come to the circle. I press the letter S scale from the keyboard, and I shrink it. And then I press the letter P of position, and I change its position. I play it from the beginning. Our animation is ready. After that, you can place this line over the text you want to emphasize this circle and tweak it. If you change the mode values here to multiply, for example, when selecting the circle, you will also give a permeable pen effect. Look, just now the normal value was overlapping the text in this way. With the multiply option, you can integrate it a bit more with the background. It will look a little more realistic. Of course, it depends on what you want to do. If you don't like this color, if you want to make it in another color, for example blue, you need to add the fill effect from the effects. I go to effects, I type fill here. You will see fill under generator. I drag it over the circle. Look, there is a red color here. By clicking on this red color, I can change the color I want in the palette that opens. To make it look like it is written in a blue color, I just need to select the blue here. You can choose whatever color you want to choose. So what will happen? It will look like it's drawn in that color, and that's it. In this tutorial, I have tried to show you how you can highlight the text you want to emphasize more effectively. There are several ways to do this, of course. The most well-known of these ways is to circle the text. And since this circle is a little more organic, I think it adds a slightly different atmosphere to the video. I hope it was useful. I hope you can easily use this in your projects. See you in the next tutorial.